This man is incredible. Andrew Strauss looking to pad the ball away. Nasser Hussain's been making the point all through this test series that if you're going to pad Warne away, you have to make sure you get close to the ball and you have to make sure the ball hits the pad. Just look at this.
Oh, this spin's big, massive. Middle stump behind his legs. Andrew Strauss cannot believe it. Look out, England. Here comes Shane Warne. Andrew Strauss, bowl Warne for six. England, 25 for one.
Well, with just 2 minutes of playing time left, it's no surprise that England have sent in their night watchman, Matthew Hoggard. Up the order for England these days at number nine, in the normal batting order, but he's in at three because Shane Warne has produced his magic from just his second delivery. One loosener, he saw it turn prodigiously, and the next ball, Strauss trying to kick the ball away, bowled round the back of his legs, hitting middle and leg stump. An incredible delivery. Perhaps it won't be as memorable as the one that dismissed Mike Gatting at Old Trafford in 1993. But a significant wicket for Shane Warne to bring up his 100 against England in England.
What a wicket to do it with. It's just unbelievable how much this ball turned. That will be going through England's line tomorrow. He is a genius, and he's very happy. Look out, England. Tomorrow, Shane Warne will get back into this game. That is just unbelievable. You've seen the right thing there. That's turned. That ball has turned a very, very long way.
Two men catching on the offside and a back pad. Oh! Leg slip as well. This is the problem the left-hander has. He sees the ball pitching in the rough, doesn't want to play it. But that's turned 2.5 feet. 2.5 feet that's turned. Well, it's better technique so far from Hoggard than Strauss.
Shot has paid dividends for Australia, not for the man playing the shot, Kevin Peterson.
Well, Warne wins the battle. Patience game. Kevin Peterson didn't have to play that ball outside leg stump, but one thing you will see, that is one of the best catches you will ever see from a wicketkeeper. That is hard to do. Out of the rough, sweep shot. Sure whether he even hit that, but that's a great take from Adam Gilchrist. He's very happy. Little shot from the front on view. Here we go, out of the rough, sweeping against it. I'm not sure whether he's hit that. Might have hit the glove at the front. Kevin Peterson departs for 20. Got Gilchrist, bowl Warne, and now England are 72 for 5. This is a very interesting decision, tough one. Closer look. Well, it's not the greatest decision. It's an amazing take from Adam Gilchrist.
Has bowled some beautiful delivery, Shane Warne. I agree with you there, Darren. I think he can consider himself a bit lucky. The only part that we can definitely say it has touched is his elbow. Perhaps the glove on the way through to the body, but that's just a perhaps. Not too sure with the Curtin, could have been 100% sure that ball touched the glove, and he isn't convinced. Another look at that dismissal. Don't think that ball hit anything other than body and elbow.
Hit everything, but the main bit, the bat and the glove. Anyone watching, that is an unbelievable take from Adam Gilchrist.
Very interesting field placing on the offside.
playing again at a ball pitching outside leg stump, which wasn't necessary.
Well, there we go. Again, they're happy. Ian Bell didn't have to play that one, young fella, but he did. He chose to. And Shane Warne, it's going to be very hard for the England batsman. They're playing at the ball every time. Here we go. It's going to pitch outside leg stump. He could have picked that away instead. Again, very, very good catch from Adam Gilchrist. It's been exceptional this morning, Adam Gilchrist. Shane Warne picks up another wicket. Australia back on top. Ian Bell departs for 21. Caught Gilchrist, bowled Warne. 75 for 6 now, England.
That's the wicket, Ian Bell. No reason to play at this bumble, is there?
No, he's outside at leg stump, Shane Warne, and he's quite happy to bowl that line as long as England keep playing at the ball. Tremendously difficult, of course. He's the best ever leg spinner. He keeps well to him, doesn't he, Gilchrist?
Played at that one. Matt Hayes is the man in the slip cordon. He doesn't drop many.
A look back in anger by Ashley Giles. He's kicked the ball away so well, and he would look at this delivery and think, do I need to play it? He's opted to play it. It's a vicious spinner again. It's a low spinner. Matthew Hayden, very, very tidy in that slip position. And it's Warne again. Hard spun. Pitches outside. Yes, it does. Takes the outside edge. Matthew Hayden does the rest. It's Ashley Giles. These are anxious times for England. He's gone for 8, 131 for 8.
Well, they're appealing to everything. First it was the LBW, but I think he might have been given out caught. That's wicket number 598 for Shane Warne. You can see there Rudy Curtson signalling that he has been given out caught.
Well, this might be any which way. First ball, Steve Harmison. Warne again, the predator. It's a legger. Where does it pitch? It pitches round about leg stump. It rattles into the pads. Does it take the outside edge? It's caught on the offside. I think that's a nick. 2-2, Shane Warne, 598, career for him. There's the catch. Harmison, just one delivery. England 131 for 9. It's my ball. This is the end of Steve Harmison. A big push forward. Yeah, it's off the outside edge, isn't it? It's the pad, it's the bat. Ricky Ponting, captain, takes that catch. Pfeiffer.
Well, that's pretty convincing. Takes Shane Warne on to 599 Test match wickets. He finishes with 6 for 46. Best bowling ever by an Australian on this ground. Australia need 282 to win this second NPAT Test match and go 2-0 up in the series. But what a job Andrew Flintoff's done for England. Listen to this crowd. See him off the field. Injured before lunch, remember. He battled on. 73 he made with some blistering shots. 6 fours and 4 sixes for Flintoff. England eventually all out in their second innings for 182, leaving Australia needing 282 for victory. Here he is, that man Warne, haunting England all the way. 23 overs and one ball, 7 maidens, 6 for 46.